Hey, craft beer fans, thank you so much for tuning in to our first ever virtual variety show, Mixed Bag. My name's Katie Stinchin. I'm the executive director of the Massachusetts Brewers Guild, and we exist to both protect and promote the interests of craft brewers across the Commonwealth. Like all of the breweries we serve, we have to reinvent ourselves a little bit right now, particularly the way that we fundraise. Our two beer festivals, Power Beer Fest and the Great Mass Collab, unfortunately can't take place, and they usually generate about half of our operating income. So we hope that until it's safe for all of us to be together again, drinking awesome beer, playing cornhole, and listening to music, that Mixed Bag will bring a little bit of the Massachusetts craft beer culture right into your living room. So get comfy, order delivery, open your favorite Massachusetts beer, and maybe your wallet too, and help us keep Massachusetts brewing. To learn more, visit www.massbrewersguild.org/donate. Cheers and enjoy the show.
Mike, what's up, man? How you been? Oh, it's been pretty crazy, I know. I've been working from home. A lot of meetings, a lot of calls, it's awful.
Cheers, guys, enjoy. I hope you're enjoying working from home.
I am not.
Please stop. Citrus, lemon, lime, and fish.
Rebuttal. Rebuttal. Oh! I'm getting a little cabin fever. I might have watched a little too much of Tiger King and, and got a little crazy with that.
What are you doing?
Yeah, I stocked up. Clown Shoes Beer, Double Dry Hop Zen Garden New England IPA. It has the Grim Reaper on the can, tending bonsai trees in his Zen garden. Oh, dude, it's really good. Highly recommended. I don't even need to go outside anymore. I find inner peace with every sip. Honestly, each sip is mind-blowing. Yeah, dude, get some. Nice. Cheers. This sip's for you, brother. May you find your inner Zen garden.
Place to kick back after a long day with the kids. You can listen to music if there's a band, drink a beer and let your kids run wild. Management lets anything go, so you can drink without the cost of a babysitter. There's a large play area in the front of the band where the kids can go and do whatever they want. It doesn't get better than that. I know this is sarcasm, but I think it's a compliment.
Big and noisy. Very busy on the weekends. Extremely kid friendly. Beer was okay. Bunch of IPAs on tap. Wish there was a better selection, just not an IPA fan. But at the time of this review, we had a lager, sour, saison, and a stout.
I was not carded, so bartenders need more basic training. The pickles tasted like pure vinegar. The other reviews by this customer include Cracker Barrel and her gynecologist's office.
This is a 2-star review of our Munich Helles Lager. Meh, lagery.
This is a review for Raspberry Awakening. Poop.
I felt alive. Timberland reads bad views.
How's it going, you guys? My name is Carly Tuft. Thanks so much for tuning in to Mixed Bag, and make sure you're supporting Massachusetts craft beer. This song is a little Boston Strong theme song I wrote called Keep On Running. It's the feeling of freedom you can't take away. Being in Boston on Patriots Day. Cause if there's one thing we do well, we keep on running, 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 running. When the shock instead of hiding away. Keep on running, running, running. The heartbeat of the city is in every step, and you can sense the beauty in every sunrise and sunset. We won't slow down till we've won, so we keep on running, 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 running. Our underdog attitudes keep us in the game. Never say never's, this town's claim to fame. And when the weather's rough, it makes our skin real tough to keep on running.
Hey everyone, Matt Mulligan and Ryan Farrell of Hawk Visuals here. We are super happy to be partnering with Mass Brewers Guild to present Mixed Bag to you. Get out there, support your local brewery, and also support Mass Brewers Guild. Cheers.
Cheers.
Hey, this is Joe from Springdale Beer Company coming to you from the barrel room today. I'm going to show you some really fun ways to play with beer outside of pouring it into a beer glass. One of my favorite things to do is to cocktail with beer, and I love doing that with sour beers. So beers that we age in barrels for acidification with fruit really take a really nice place of a shrub in a cocktail. So a shrub is typically a fruit and vinegar-based combination that you could pair with a spirit to create a really fun and fruity cocktail. You can do the same thing with beer, and you get some really fun bubbles along the way. So I'm gonna do it with some ingredients from my house that are really simple. You can kind of sub things in and out as you please. The ingredients for this cocktail are simple sugar, so 1-to-1 water and sugar. I'm using white rum from Bully Boy, our friends in Boston. You can use dark rum, you can use vodka, you can use tequila, really anything you want, anything you really like and you think that fits in the cocktail. And I'm going to use our Fruits and Shoots, which is a barrel-aged golden beer aged on mangoes and basil. So what I'm going to do is just a stirred cocktail. It's kind of a riff on, I guess, on a daiquiri. So I'm going to make one, and we're going to do that right now. So I'm going to start with 2 parts of white rum. This is made by our friends at Bully Boy in Boston, as I said. Can't wait to get back to that space and have a cocktail there. 2 parts of that, to which I'm going to add 1 part of simple sugar, simple syrup. If you have basil around, you can toss some basil into muddle, which is nice. When you use basil, you want to make sure you kind of rough it up a bit. You get some flavor and some fragrance out of that. I'm going to add a dash of bitter to it. This is just Angostura aromatic bitters. A couple drops. I'm going to stir that together in my little cocktail stirrer here. This is from Boston Shaker in Somerville. Shout out to those guys too. Fun little toy. I'm gonna pour this into a glass. And I always like to top with the beer. Just because you don't want to lose any of that carbonation if you can avoid it. Because I have some mango on hand, we're in season, we're gonna drop some mango in there. I'm gonna top with two parts beer. So Fruits and Shoots is a fun beer where we had some beer aging on mangoes and we really thought we needed an extra punch to it. And that extra punch, we had been playing around with basil in a different beer and it really worked quite nicely. And when we roughed up some basil, tossed it in the beer, it really like balanced the cocktail, the beer really well. And I think it works really nicely in the cocktail too. So again, you can, I tossed some mango in here, you can toss some basil in here too. You definitely can toss a cocktail umbrella in there if you like. And cheers to having fun with beer.
Hi everyone, my name's Sarah. I'm with Medusa Brewing over in Hudson, Mass. And I'm here today to just kind of switch it up, do something a little different. We're gonna be using some of our beers to make some fun cocktails for the summer. And so I'm just gonna walk through a few of these and hopefully you can try some of these at home and or make your own riffs off of them. So here we go. So first, we're just gonna start off with a classic. Everyone loves a good Manhattan. After dinner, a little dessert drink. So this is my very professional mixing glass. I'm gonna start off with an ounce or two of your favorite bourbon. Did about an ounce and a half in there. Gotta have some sweet vermouth. You're doing a Manhattan, so we'll do an ounce of some good sweet vermouth. And here comes the twist. Instead of bitters, which is a little bit more traditional, we're gonna go with a West Coast style IPA. Ours is called Eruption. And I'm going for something a little bit more intense and bitter, which is why I'm looking for those West Coast hops. You want something to make up for the punch of that nice strong bitter. So we're gonna do about an ounce of this. It doesn't have to be fresh. What's actually great about this cocktail is really you're going for the flavor profile of the beer. So after maybe you've finished one, just leave a little ounce left. You can let it sit out. It's okay if it gets a little flat. We're just gonna add it for a little bit of flavor. So give us a nice stir with a Manhattan. Never shake, you always stir. So what that means is just make sure to just agitate the ice as little as possible. Get this nice and cold. Grab a nice glass here. And I am a firm believer in a good cherry. They're a little expensive, but they're totally worth it. I promise you, once you try them, you'll know. And that's our beer Manhattan. All right, so for our next cocktail, we're gonna do a little gin. I love gin when it gets warm. It's just nice and some of those herbal, floral, juniper aromas and notes really, really make summer really nice and fresh. So we're gonna start off with an ounce of gin. You can use whatever gin you like. I prefer a little bit more of the floral American style gins than I do some of those more botanical, like Tanqueray juniper, but whatever gin you prefer. I squeezed a little fresh lemon juice earlier, so we're gonna use a little bit of fresh lemon juice. I just did about an ounce of the gin. We're gonna do about an ounce of the lemon. We're gonna do kind of a riff on a bee's knees here. So a bee's knees is usually lemon juice, some honey, as well as gin. And so I have a little bit of honey here. I'm just gonna do about a half ounce of this because we don't wanna over-sweeten it. And then here comes the fun part. We're gonna shake this up. Get a nice, pretty glass. So you can drink this as is. It's just going to be a really small pour of the bee's knees. But the twist here, we're going to add some fresh ice. And we are actually going to grab a nice New England style IPA. I went with a New England style because you're really looking for some of those citrus notes, some of those grassier hops, a little bit softer on the palate. It's not going to disrupt the entire cocktail, but it just adds a little boost of flavor and goes really, really well with some of those aromatics with the gin. So we're just going to use that to top it off. About 3 ounces is good. And of course, with this bee's knees, you always have to give it a little bit of love with some lemon. And that's it. Those are some fun summer cocktails for you. Just using some of our fun favorite beers for the summer that we have coming up. We hope you can try some of these at home and let us know what you think. Thanks so much.
Okay. Thanks for tuning in to Mixed Bag and supporting Massachusetts craft beer. God knows, I drink enough of it. I've been on a treehouse, Wormtown, a greater good binge during quarantine. I've been quarantining in Sturbridge, Massachusetts, which is another home for me, and I love it in Massachusetts, and I grew up here. And all right, thanks for having me. Mixed Bag. Yeah. When you're waking up, down on everything, I will be a song when you don't want to sing. The strength you need to face the day is in my back pocket, baby. I will be a curse when you're freezing cold. Never be the one to ever break your soul. I will be a rock when you want to roll. Just take my hand, baby. I'm gonna shine down on you like the morning sun. I'm gonna shine down, cause I got nothing but love. Yeah, I'm gonna light up your sky. I swear, girl, did I? I'm gonna shine down on you like the pouring rain. I swear, I'm gonna shine down on you like you shine down. Hand on my heart, this is my confession. If I'm ever gone, give myself to heaven. You're my ticket in, my greatest blessing. You make me better, baby. I wanna give you praise for changing everything. I wanna give you thanks for showing me the way. Alright. I'm gonna shine down on you like the morning sun. I'm gonna got nothing but love. I'm gonna light up your sky. I swear, girl, did I? I'm gonna shine down on you like it's pouring rain. Swear, I'm gonna shine down on you like you shine down on me. Alright. God made me, that much is true. But he knew he could do better, baby, so God made you. I'm gonna shine down on you like the morning sun. I'm gonna shine down, cause I've got nothing but love. I'm gonna light up your sky. I swear, girl, did I? I'm gonna shine down even when it's pouring rain. Swear, I'm gonna shine down on you like you shine down on me. Yeah. Very good.
Did this man transport 50 tons of hops by kayak when he was just 10 years old?
I was pushing about 50 tons in a year. I was much lighter because I was only 10, so there was more room for the hops.
Beer Time opens a can of worms tonight at 8.
Great. Good afternoon. My name is Dan Canary, CEO and co-founder of Mass Bay Brewing Company, or the Harpoon Brewery.
I'm Warren Dibble. I'm the CFO at Mass Bay Brewing Company. Cheers.
Cheers, Warren. I know we're supposed to pour it in a glass, but let's have a sip first.
Old school.
Mmm. Damn, that's good. Harpoon for the front line. This is a very new product for us to have packaged, but it's actually the oldest beer that we've ever made, Harpoon Ale, dating back to the summer of 1986, when we started the brewery, almost 3.5 decades ago. Mild, kind of English-style ale, fruity esters, subtle hop. It's a beautiful, balanced beer, isn't it?
It's delicious. When I first started working in May of 1989, it was the only product that we made. It was in draft in 12-ounce bottles, and I delivered a lot of it on one delivery truck, Alpharet Boston.
You know what we've always got to remember to tell these young people, Warren, is that not only did you deliver, but it was 15.5 Hoff Steven kegs, the fat boys, with no handles.
Two at a time.
So delivering every one was dangerous. We can kind of say that now. And we delivered thousands of them over the years that we were delivering it. But this is a product that we are making special for the frontline workers during the time of the pandemic. Doctors, nurses, grocery store, you know, checkout folks, stocking shelves, delivery people, all those wonderful people, public safety officials, police, fire, EMTs, that are kind of putting themselves at risk every day, kind of to keep us healthy, keep us fed. So the least we can do is to keep everybody beveraged.
I am Jack from Jack's Abbey Craft Lagers, and I'm here with two of our Pilsners, Post Shift Pilsner, and our dry hop version, dry hop Post Shift. And wanted to talk a little bit about what the differences are between these two beers, and why each one of them is unique in their own way. So you're probably more familiar with our regular Post Shift. This has been a core year-round beer for a few years now. Comes in 16-ounce cans and 12 packs. We built our Pilsner around one specific hop that we get from a local farm in the Hallertau region called Hallertau Blanc. And this beer has an assertive bitterness without being over-the-top hoppy, and clean malt flavors like a traditional Pilsner would be. Of course, it's decocted, it's naturally carbonated, and uses all our traditional Bavarian-style brewing techniques. On the other hand, we have our dry hop Post Shift. And while we do use a lot of the same traditional techniques as our regular Pilsner, we are trying to be cutting edge on the innovation side with this product. So this is a beer that we add two additional hop doses to. One we add at fermentation, where we're relying on biotransformation of our Hallertau Blanc with our lager yeast, in addition to a secondary dry hop charge of Hallertau Blanc to really amp up the hop aroma and hop intensity in this beer. So this is more of your standard Pilsner, everyday drinking beer, and this is sort of the really hoppy interpretation of what a Pilsner could be. And of course, we as American brewers can take liberties and really push the boundaries of lager brewing. So thank you for watching, and I hope that answers your questions about what the differences between these two beers are.
When it comes to beer in Massachusetts, anything goes.
Craft beer is everywhere. No need to hoard it. If it's good, we'll drink it.
That's why we got Drinking at Wormtown. Over 13 of the coolest beer styles available in draft, 4-pack, 6-pack, 32-ounce growler, 64-ounce growler, 500-milliliter bottle, and 2 cassette tapes.
You'll
You'll be amazed at what you find when drinking at Wormtown. West Coast IPAs, lagers, imperial stouts.
Drinking at Wormtown has the beers you know, the beers you love, and the beers you just can't get anywhere else. Because there are taproom only releases and they're only available here.
Can't touch this.
Thing to say about drinking at Wormtown.
You're unbelievable. To order, ignore the number on your screen and go to wormtownbrewery.com. Curbside pickup is available. Drinking at Wormtown is something we can all enjoy.
Hi, my name is Adam Leibowitz. I'm the Director of Sales and Marketing here at Mighty Squirrel in Waltham. And we're happy to be a part of the Mass Brewers Guild's Mixed Bag. Today what we thought we'd do is sample Sour Face. Sour Face is our raspberry and kiwi Berliner Weiss. It clocks in about 5% ABV. And it's just a perfect ale for the summer. And we'll find out why. So let's do a little pouring. I also want to apologize. I tried doing this sampling from the brewery, but there was a lot of activity on the brewing team. So, it was a little noisy. So, anyway, let's get to pouring. So, as you can see, just a nice, deep, lush red there. Foam retention. A little fancy swirling. And right away, you know, you get that raspberry, very bright. You can almost smell the tartness from the raspberry and the kiwi. Yeah. All right. Cheers. Yeah, and again, what we love about this beer is the layers to it. You know, I think at the start, you get that nice, bright raspberry, you know, and then it goes into kind of a tartness, followed by a touch of sweet. And then it finishes with that kiwi, which kind of, I guess, dries it up a little bit, gives it a little more of that sour finish. And it kind of just leaves you wanting another sip, which I do, so. So anyway, Sour Face is available year-round from us. We brew a little more, obviously, in the summertime, so you should have no problems finding it at your local liquor store. And again, we're happy to support the Mixed Bag, and cheers.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, Danny.
Oh, hi there.
Bright idea has become a member of the Massachusetts Craft Brewers Guild.
Because we are a brewery in Massachusetts, we paid our fees on time.
How does Mass Brewers Guild help us?
Really, they help us by helping establish camaraderie with other breweries in Massachusetts. They've also keep us up to date on what's going on at the state level. And they have availability to abundance of resources that help us both educationally and to become just a better brewery in general. Cheers.
Hey everyone, Sam Hamler here, co-founder of Jack's Abbey Craft Lagers and president of the Mass Brewers Guild. We hope you're enjoying the show and getting a behind the scenes look at some of your favorite breweries and beers. The Mass Brewers Guild is really important to me, especially in times like this. It's a really challenging time for the industry right now, and getting together, advocating for the help we need to survive this is really what the Brewers Guild is all about. We're protecting and promoting the interests of the Massachusetts beer scene, and that's what we're doing right now. It's really meaningful to, you know, be able to open as soon as we can and in a safe way, and all the things that we need to be able to run our businesses and flourish again once we get through this. If we've made you laugh, taught you something new, or kept you entertained, we hope you'll consider supporting our work by visiting massbrewersguild.org and making a donation. I hope you enjoy the second half of Mixed Bag.
What we have here is a beer geek searching for a new beer. And by God, he's onto something. This beautiful floral IPA, so fresh, so clean. And this ale, so sweet, never stood a chance. And this stout, right into the beer geek's hand. But a lager he's been searching for months. And by God, he's got it. So beautiful. The beer geek now can sit back, relax, and wait until the next new beer comes out.
Thing we use to stir up the mash, which is the mixture of grain and water that we make beer from.
Sounds right. Next, we've got hops. Wow. Just an ingredient in beer gives beer aroma, bitterness, some flavor. Moving on.
That's right. Car seat. Okay, so this is a space up on the brew house where we have all of our controls and our meters and stuff like that. It's you know, it's where we kind of, it's like, hey, Tommy, why don't you get in the car seat and drive the beer? Like that. So, and our next term is?
Barley. Just another ingredient. Gives the beer flavor, I guess.
That's right. And next we have the annexation of Puerto Rico. So this is when the brewmaster comes up with like a really complicated recipe. It's like, hey, Tommy, 7 hop additions. What is this, the annexation of Puerto Rico? It's also a reference to the 1994 film Little Giants.
Wow, nostalgic and interesting. Thank you.
You're welcome. And our next term is
yeast, another ingredient. Excellent.
Cool. Our next term is mash paddle. This is a potato masher. It's what we use to make mashed potatoes, which are a hearty and inexpensive snack that brewers just love.
Swerve. The next one is water. Water.
Hilarious. Tummy tuck. This is great. So sometimes when you're reaching really far into a tank trying to scrub it clean, you get a little crease on your stomach there. And you know, it's like, hey Tommy, nice tummy tuck. What were you, scrubbing fermenters? Like that. Moving on.
Pint glass. Give me pint glass. Excellent.
You can have the next one. I'm sure the next one's great.
Better be.
Anyway. Highway Scooter! I can't say this on camera!
Hey guys, Alex Rowan here from Treehouse Brewing Company. Thanks for tuning in to The Mixed Bag and supporting Massachusetts Craft Brew. Cheers.
Out on the floor, you can fall into the door, scream out at the top of your lungs what you really need. Could you be me? We can flip off anyone, there ain't no fighting out one. But when the bar shuts down at two, where are you? When the bar closes at two, where is your crew? 'Cause we're still drinking, straight up not thinking about what to do the next day. And that tab will never pay. Keep on running, this engine's humming. Oh no, I see the sun, it must be seven. I think I'm drinking in heaven. No, hangovers up here, we're all in the clear. So hangovers up here, every look you get is real. Every taste and touch and feel, the one night stand, the nightly routine. No phone calls the next day, try to be here next Sunday. No steps off this wagon, I know you. 'Cause we're still drinking, straight up not thinking about what to do the next day. Time will never pay. Keep on running, this engine's humming. Oh no, I see the sun. Oh no, I see the sun. And I'm still drinking, straight up not thinking about what to do the next day. And that's how I'll never pay. I keep on running, this engine's humming. Oh no, I see the sun, it must be seven. I think I'm drinking in heaven.
Hey guys, that last song was called Hangovers in Heaven. Me and some of the guys at work thought it'd be a cool idea to write a song about not getting hungover in heaven and being able to do whatever you want.
Hi everybody, if you can see me through the steam, this is Will Myers, brewmaster at the Cambridge Brewing Company in Cambridge, Massachusetts. We were founded in 1989, and we're well known locally and around the globe as being one of the most creative and innovative breweries in the land. Some of your other favorite breweries in the Northeast and across the U.S. can claim CBC as their alma mater, as they began their brewing careers here at CBC. I'm talking about our friends at Wormtown Brewing Company, Samuel Adams, Honest Way, and Brado Brew House, just to name a few. We'd planned our 31st anniversary celebration for the beginning of this past May, but like many of us, we all saw those plans change due to circumstances beyond our control. Today I'm brewing a little Czech-inspired amber lager, which should be ready for everybody to enjoy around the middle of June. Excuse me while I grab another bag. This is fun, right? We are Massachusetts Brewers Guild members because, as one of a handful of breweries who helped found this industry back in the 80s, we know the value in advocating for small, family-run businesses. Our industry not only employs thousands of people in the Commonwealth, but these small, family-run businesses also keep our money in the local economy, as opposed to funneling that money to shareholders of major corporate multinational breweries and organizations. These corporate breweries don't care about you, they care about their shareholders and their bottom line. Massachusetts breweries, on the other hand, care about our communities. Thanks for watching Mixed Bag. Please consider visiting us at massbrewersguild.org and make a donation if you can. Thanks and cheers. If only this video had smell-o-vision, you'd understand why I like this job so much.
I'm gonna give you a little quick tour, and then I'm gonna take you downstairs into the new warehouse, and I'm gonna show you the on-the-fly system. Canning line, production, packaging, just giving you a little view of what goes on a normal day here. We got green going through the line. Just when you thought it was safe, Dave Boscarino banging out the coffee. Dave has recently been promoted to our coffee program, and we're very happy to have him. He's been a long time retail person and retail manager, expressed interest in doing the coffee roasting, and is now our assistant coffee roaster. And
pretty awesome. There he is. Ladies and gentlemen, the beard, Dave Boscarino. And down they go. Hey, Joe. Say hi.
Hi.
And that was Trainer Joe. He's our shipping and receiving guru. So if you look over there, you can see our retail staff getting ready for the famous on the fly. And if you look over there, you can see one person packing up cases. So we have a very strict cell phone policy in any of our places where our employees are working or production's happening. So I have to tell you that you won't see any of these people with their cell phones out. But we can say hi, say hi. Hi, everybody. This is some of our great retail staff, retail team, all the team members here getting ready to start selling cans to people in the On the Fly program, keeping it real and keeping it safe here during the COVID time. Say hi, everybody.
Hi.
Say, we love the Mass Brewers Guild.
Yeah. Hi, Mass Brewers Guild. Hope you long time.
So the retail managers are looking at me funny because I'm not supposed to have a cell phone out, but I'm doing a special video for the Mass Brewers Guild. So say hi, Mass Brewers Guild.
Yay.
There's Stephanie and Danielle. They're running the show down here, keeping everything safe, happy, and very good for all of you.
Woo.
This is our new warehouse, and we're very happy to be in our new warehouse. Just giving you a peek. And there's your peek. One more time for y'all. Bye, Mass Brewers Guild. Thanks for having us.
Workers are doing while they drink Mayflower beer.
Summer while checking on the bees.
Riley, give me another beer. you.
I'm happy to drink Mayflower anytime, anywhere, with anyone. Cheers.
Welcome to the Night Shift Brewing Tap Room. We're so happy you're here to join us. We are in now our 8th year of operation. We've got this beautiful facility. It's actually our second one. The first facility that we had was located about a mile away in Chelsea. This is just a bit of an upgrade in size and equipment, which we'll see in a few moments. We've got a beautiful bar here, 24 taps, lots of varieties of beer on at any given time. We've got our flagship beers, Whirlpool, Pale Ale, Santilli, IPA, the 87 Double IPA. And then we like to have a variety of different styles. So, you know, everything from lots of different fun lagers, stouts, sours, barrel-aged stuff. Anytime you come in, there's always something new and exciting on there. Over here, we have our second location for a bar. About 3 years ago, and this is great because between the two rooms we have a combined capacity of about 450 people. So we can accommodate small parties, large parties, all kinds of events. It's really become a great place for the whole community to get together and come have a few brews together. One of our most popular areas, of course, weather permitting. This is our outdoor patio. We actually have it shrunk down to winter size footprint, but in the summer we expand it out in the parking lot. Out towards the street. It's really great. You know, lawn games out here. Dogs are frolicking about.
What's up, Brett?
It's a lot of fun. Great place to come and get some sun, although as you can see, I'm a ginger, so I avoid the sun. Terrifies me. Come on back this way and we'll go look at the production area. Take a quick walk through our beautifully stocked to-go fridges, where our taproom team worked very hard to make sure that only the freshest beer is available to our customers all the time. It's been great. During the shutdown, our taproom team has been very, very busy. They've really been cranking to take care of customers and get their beer in a timely manner. In fact, we recently started a local area delivery service, which has also been very busy and very successful. So that's been a change we didn't see coming, but something that has worked out very well, and we get great feedback from our customers. Right now we're gonna walk through our tank farm. So this is where we have our fermenters. So this is where the beer is actually made. We've got some of our teammates out there making magic happen. Tyler's dropping off some fresh beer in the cooler.
What up?
Fresh beer in the cooler, huh?
Sir.
So much, this guy.
Sir.
And this is our brew house. A brand new, state-of-the-art Braukamm from Germany. 60-barrel brew house. 3 vessels. Come on up, get a little closer. It's a little hot, so don't get too close. This is our mash tun, lager tun. This is our boil kettle. This is our whirlpool. And then those vessels down on the end, those are our hot and cold water storage tanks, liggers, if you will. And this fancy doodad, I have no idea how to operate because I'm not a brewer. I'm a lowly production coordinator. These guys work their wizardry, and I just make sure they have all the raw materials they need to do it. It is also very hot up here, so I'm going to get off the grass. Go on this way. Let's go take a look at a cooler part of the facility. That's a temperature joke. This is our canning line. That filler. It's been how many cans per hour can this canning line do?
How many cans per hour?
It's like 68 a minute. So 68 a minute times 60. It's a lot of cans. I don't think I can come up with a better way to close out the tour. Saying cheers to all my friends and family in the Mass Brewer Guild. Thank you to everyone for supporting us. Brewers, guilds, customers, you're all wonderful. Can't wait to share a beer with you when this all is over. Cheers.
Thank you guys so much once again. My name is Carly Teft, and thanks so much for tuning into Mixed Bag. Make sure you are supporting Massachusetts craft beer, and I hope you'll support this song to go along with it. This is called Better Off at a Bar. I know I should be out, feeling the neon of the lights, lying on my couch. Why you all that's on my mind? Cause you ain't called me in a week. I'm losing all of my sleep over this. Now I'm thinking about what if I'm better off at a bar. Open a tap instead of open my heart. Open a glass instead of you in my arms. I know what we are. I'm sick of being a backup plan. Call me when you can. That ain't who I am. Don't let this go too far. I'm better off at a bar. Oh, oh, oh. I'm better off at a bar. Oh, oh, oh. Thinking back to when I wake up lying in your sheets, tangled in my hair, with you always lying to me. Can't let myself let go. Cause first I gotta know if you're over this. But I can't keep wondering what if I'm better off at a bar. Open a tap instead of opening my heart. Open the glass instead of you in my arms. I know what we are. I'm sick of being a backup plan. Call me when you can. That ain't who I am. Don't let this go too. Once again, my name is Carly Teft. Appreciate it.
It's a slippery boy.
Oh, shit. Oh, it did not explode.
I got it. Just fucking rock it. Yep.
Yeah.
Hey, how you doing? My name is Matt DeLuca, co-owner and head brewer at Castle Island Brewing Company in Norwood, Massachusetts.
Thanks for tuning in to Mixed Bag. If you like what you see, please go ahead and make a donation at massbrewersguild.org. Appreciate it.
Hi, I'm Jim Cook, the brewer and founder of Sam Adams. And first, I want to thank you for your support of the Mass Brewers Guild. And second, I want to share not one, but two things, which I think are kind of cool. I have them in my home office. And the first is this thing, which if you see it, it's got the, you know, the rings of a tree. It looks like wood. And that's what it is. It is a wooden brick, and it came from a special place. It came from my great-great-grandfather's brewery in St. Louis, where the recipe for Sam Adams Boston Lager came from. And there's a little bit of a story behind this brick. It was taken from the remnants of the Lewis Cook Brewery in 1984. I was on a trip there with my dad to go to the Master Brewers Convention, which was in St. Louis then, and we met up with Charlie Papazian at the site of my great-great-grandfather's brewery. And my dad took a cornerstone out of the brewery, and of course, he lost that. But Charlie took this brick, and it was from the Cooper shop where they would repitch the wooden barrels. So they'd melt pitch down, coat the inside of the wooden barrels to keep the beer from contacting the wood and spoiling. So after 160 years, this brick still smells of, you know, tree sap, turpentine, that pitch that came out of softwood pine trees that was used to coat the inside of wooden barrels. And 13 years ago, Charlie sent me this brick. I actually have his letter because one doesn't want to forget gratuitous acts of kindness. And Charlie was kind enough to send it to me because my great-great-grandfather's brewery had been torn down. Anheuser-Busch was nearby. They expanded. They bought it. They tore it down. They turned it into a parking lot. This brick is all that's left of my great-great-grandfather's brewery. And second is another kind of weird thing. It's this. And you're probably wondering what it is. Kind of looks like coal. If you actually look on the other side, it has the contours of the inside of a wooden barrel. And this, believe it or not, is Triple Bock. Now I'll explain why this is Triple Bock, but Triple Bock was a sort of seminal beer in a bunch of ways. It was the first extreme beer. It was the first beer in history to get to 18% alcohol. And it was also the first beer to be aged in used spirits barrels, which you would think has been around forever, but it wasn't. Everybody thought it was illegal until we convinced the BATF to allow it in 1993, and that began the barrel aging revolution in craft brewing. Now, how could this be Triple Bock? Well, this is from one of those very early barrels, you know, getting on to 30 years old, and it evaporated. All of the Triple Bock inside there evaporated. The alcohol and the water went away. The angels took the entire share. And so what we have is super concentrated Triple Bock. Just add water and add alcohol and you'll bring it back to life. So thank you for listening to my crazy stories. Cheers.
They say his reflection is even more handsome than him in real life. He invented the first face mask to hide his intimidating smile. He says a well-balanced diet is a beer in each hand. His only worthy beer pong partner is himself. He's currently voicing over this video. He is the most interesting beer guy in the world.
I don't always support guilds, but when I do, I support Mass Brewers Guild. Drink local, my friends.
Favorite memories of Barrel House. I'd have to say I had my son's first birthday at Barrel House, set up on the brew floor, and everything was all set. It was kind of a hectic morning, getting herding cats all in into a first birthday party. But yeah, it went off, and it was Kids Day, so it was merry chaos already. And yeah, it made things kind of special, being able to bring, you know, my family kind of into my work family, which was nice. Which kind of parlays into what I love about Barrel House. It has and really exemplifies in my mind that easygoing conviviality of beer. Beer's got this great kind of culture of a hearth and being familiar or close to home and comfortable. And I think that's something Barrel House does really well. You come in, we're not too big, and you're not home, but you're close. And I think that's the attitude that, I mean, brought me in to work there. So, yeah, it's kind of my favorite things about Barrel House.
So my name's Sam James, and it's nice to be here on Mixed Bag. Mixed Bag. I've been mixing it up. It's been fun, a little quarantine fun. I know retail and restaurants and you, the craft brewers, are hurting right now. But listen, if there's people like me in the world, we're going to get back to some serious drinking very soon. So hang in there. All right, I got one more for you. This is a song called Beautiful Life. I wrote it with a good friend of mine, BB Rexa. And it was this theme song to a movie called Abominable on DreamWorks at the end of last year. And here you go. Enjoy your evening.
I was lost, you found me, hiding in the shadows from our destiny. Then you saw things that no one else could see, and save me when I was my worst enemy. It feels so good to be alive, just you and me tonight. Don't wake me up from this high. I feel it in my veins. I'll never be the same. I'll never be the same. Just two things wanna get by. Can't buy from feeling sad. My pretty little paradise. My pretty little paradise. It feels so good to be alive. You and me tonight. Don't wake me up from this high.
Thanks for having me. Stay strong.
Thank you.
Thanks for watching. Please visit massbrewersguild.org to make a donation.
Thank you for watching. Please visit massbrewers.org and donate.
Thank you all for watching. Please visit massbrewersguild.org and make a donation.
Thank you for watching. Please donate at massbrewersguild.org. Cheers.
Hey, my name is Ian, one of the bartenders here. Thank you for watching. If you could go on massbrewersguild.org and contribute, it'd be really great and be really appreciated. Thank you very much.
Hindsight,
yeah.
Hindsight.
What's in this? It tastes like orange and tangerine.
Yeah, and some healthy junk, too.
What are you doing,
man?
Come on.
Problem, boys?
Oh!
Oh, you missed it, though.
Hindsight. The stuff kids go for.
Hi, my name is Liz Lidwell, and welcome to my family farm, Four Star Farms. We're a hop farm out in Western Mass, supplying a lot of Massachusetts and New England breweries with our super delightful, wicked aromatic, and sometimes dank hops. Just how many hops do we grow in a season? Enough for you folks at home to drink between 2 to 3 million pints each year. Now don't go taking that as a challenge, but do keep drinking local Massachusetts craft beer. It helps keep us farming, it keeps our friends brewing, and it keeps you from being thirsty. We're out in one of our hop yards, and our growing season is really just hitting its stride now. As you can see, most of these beautiful hop plants have already made it halfway to their final destination, the top of this 19-foot trellis system, and they should all be to the top by the solstice later this month. These plants can literally grow up to 3 feet in a week, and sometimes it feels like you can watch them do that. Once they hit the top of the cable, the plants will start getting fuller and lusher, and will start developing hop cones in July and August. Quite literally, the fruits of our labor. But enough of that growing business. I'm really here to offer you a teaser to help support our friends at the Mass Brewers Guild. I'm offering up a private tour, socially distanced, to one of you, our lucky viewers, and up to four of your friends. What will it include? An all-access pass to check out our hops, and a chance to hang with yours truly. And there will be beer, made from the finest Massachusetts breweries, using the finest Massachusetts ingredients. Visit massbrewersguild.org to learn more. And hurry up and enter to win. These beers are tasty, and I'm pretty thirsty. Thanks for watching Mixed Bag.
Danny Babineau here. I'm one of the co-founders of Redemption Rock Brewing Company and a board member with the Massachusetts Brewers Guild. We hope that you enjoyed Mixed Bag tonight, learn something new about Massachusetts beer while supporting the Mass beer community. One of the reasons that our trade organization is so important to me is that it provides amazing networking opportunities with all of the other Massachusetts breweries to be able to connect and learn from each other, while also providing training resources, and has been a huge support of us in the times of coronavirus. If you're able to support us by making a donation at massbrewersguild.org, we'd be super grateful. Till the next time, cheers and stay safe out there. Thank you.
This next song is called Generation. It's kind of just about stepping up and doing your part.
Tell me.
me something, my new friend. Well, are you ready for what's happening? For an example, look around. Well, life is beautiful, yet sees through the sound. We'll get your head out of the clouds. And speak the truth, drink the fruit. Let this be forever long. Let this be forever long. Let this be forever long. Yeah. Well, let this be forever long. Built a sturdy bridge, now you're the chain. We're ready for a new kind of mindset. We conquer all the mountains and climb it. Focus on the love, don't look behind it. I do believe that now's the perfect time. Future is sustainable. I call BS on all the hopes and promises. I go today cause who knows what tomorrow is. I'm ready for a new generation. Do an easy job and not be wasted. A global opportunity to change things. We built a sturdy bridge, now you're the chain links. I'm ready for a new kind of mindset. To conquer all the mountains, change the climate. Focus on the love, don't look behind it. I do believe that now's the perfect time. Forever long, let this be forever long. Let this be forever long, yeah. Oh. Let this be forever long. Do an easy job and not be wasted. A global opportunity to change things. You built a sturdy bridge, now you're the chain links. I'm ready for a new kind of mindset. To conquer all the mountains, change the climate. Focus on the love, don't look behind it. I do believe that now's the perfect time.